The Sukhoi Su-30 is a twin-engine, two-seat, super-maneuverable fighter aircraft developed in the Soviet Union by Russia's Sukhoi Aviation Corporation. It is a multi-role fighter for all-weather, air-to-air, and air-to-surface deep interdiction missions. The Su-30 is considered to be one of the most successful Russian defense export programs in the past two decades. It is in service with about 12 nations, including China, Vietnam, Malaysia, Algeria, and Venezuela. The Su-30 is the backbone of the Indian Air Force, which operates around 270 Su-30 MKI jets, a unique version specifically designed for India. MKI, meaning Modernized Commercial Indian in English, is jointly developed with Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, or HAL. It is the first Su-30 family member to feature thrust vectoring control, TVC, and canards. It is interesting to note that the MKI version of Su-30 includes Israeli and French avionics. For example, the aircraft is fitted with a French-made heads-up display system and an Israeli-made electronic warfare system, as well as an advanced targeting pod. The range of 3,000 kilometers, 1,900 miles, payload capacity of up to 8,130 kilograms, 17,920 pounds, and ability to fly with a speed of Mach 2.0 make this a versatile aircraft. Over the years, India has integrated several locally built weapons into this platform. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes what indigenous Indian weapons make the Sukhoi Su-30 MKI fighter jet very lethal. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The RUDRAM missile is primarily an anti-radiation missile, ARM, designed to detect, track, and neutralize enemy radar and communication assets, which are integral to air defense systems. Its role in the suppression of enemy air defense, SEAD operations, is crucial, enabling the IAF to neutralize early warning radars, command and control systems, and surveillance systems. Typically, these are made for use against an enemy radar, although jammers and even radios used for communications can also be targeted in this manner. The primary purpose of this type of missile is to degrade enemy air defenses in the first period of a conflict in order to increase the chances of survival for the following waves of strike aircraft. Its navigation mechanism combines an inertial navigation system, INS, with GPS for mid-course guidance, ensuring accuracy over long distances. The terminal phase employs either millimeter wave active radar homing or infrared homing, depending on the variant, allowing it to engage targets with pinpoint accuracy, even if the radiation source switches off mid-flight. The capabilities are thought to be similar to the American AGM 88E AARGM. The current operational variant is RUDRAM 1, and it was inducted in 2012. This was a landmark achievement since it is India's first indigenous anti-radiation missile and reduces reliance on imported systems. RUDRAM 1 has a range of 150 kilometers or 93 miles in max speed of Mach 2.0. RUDRAM 2 and RUDRAM 3 with a range of 350 and 550 kilometers and hypersonic speed is currently under development. RUDRAM 2 has already been flight tested on May 29, 2024. ASTRA is an Indian family of all-weather beyond visual range air-to-air missiles. The missile is designed to be capable of engaging targets at varying ranges and altitudes, allowing for the engagement of both short-range targets at a distance of 20 kilometers and long-range targets up to a distance of 110 kilometers. The missile uses a smokeless solid-fueled motor that can propel the missile to a speed of Mach 4.5 and allows operation from a maximum altitude of 20 kilometers. 66,000 feet. It carries a 15-kilogram, 33-pound, high-explosive pre-fragmented warhead activated by a proximity fuse. ASTRA features mid-course inertial guidance with terminal active radar homing. The missile employs an active Ku, X-band monopulse radio frequency, RF seeker. It is equipped with electronic countermeasures to allow operation even during enemy attempts to jam the seeker using electronic countermeasures. ASTRA can be launched in both autonomous and buddy mode operation and can lock on to its target before or after it is launched. In terms of technology, this missile is comparable to many other similar imported missile systems while being much cheaper. Importantly, an extended range variant, ASTRA Mark II, is also being developed that can hit targets at a distance of up to 160 kilometers or 100 miles. To increase the missile's range and performance, a dual pulse rocket motor has been installed on it. The motor improves the kinematics during the kill phase of the missile. The variant is under testing. BrahMos is developed jointly by India's Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, and Russia's NPO, Mashinostroyenia. It is powered by a ramjet engine. BrahMos is armed with a 300 kilogram or 660 pound semi-armor piercing warhead and has a supersonic speed of Mach 3. While the warhead is crucial, it is also to be noted that being twice as heavy and almost four times as fast as a typical cruise missile, like the American Tomahawk, the BrahMos has more than 32 times kinetic energy. The combined destructive force of massive warhead and kinetic energy is lethal for even the biggest surface warships and bunkers. BrahMos has broken ships in half in several tests. The missile is hard to shoot down since it has the capability to fly extremely close to the ground or sea level to avoid missile defense systems. During the terminal phase, the missile can fly as low as 10 meters to the ground. Also, in the final stages of flight, it doesn't move in a straight line, but performs a S maneuver. BrahMos is also pretty difficult to jam since it has lots of redundancies in the guidance system, right from the INS, GPS, GLONASS, and Gagan. And it also has an active radar seeker or inertial guidance for the final phase. Its accuracy of around 1 square meter makes it suitable for precision strikes. BrahMos-A is a modified variant of its basic configuration and is specifically designed for air launch. The missile has a range of 500 kilometers, 310 miles. It features several design refinements, which include a lighter propulsion system, weight reduction, as well as redesigned fins and nose caps. Though BrahMos-A is lighter than the original BrahMos, it is still a heavy missile, and integration with a fighter aircraft required many changes that included strengthening the Su-30 MKI airframe, particularly its underbelly weapon station, the addition of new hardpoints, and modification of cockpit controls. On June 25, 2016, a modified Indian Air Force Sukhoi Su-30 MKI aircraft carried a BrahMos-A. This is the first time in the world that such a heavyweight supersonic cruise missile was integrated into a fighter aircraft. 42 Sukhoi Su-30 MKI have been modified to equip BrahMos-A, and each can carry one of these heavyweight missiles.